watch. Some UC Santa Cruz bioengineering students are designing a biofuel that they hope will lower the carbon footprint around the planet. Action News reporter Phil Gomez joins us live from Santa Cruz to explain their cutting-edge approach. Phil?
Well, that's right, Erin. The UC Santa Cruz team is made up mostly of undergraduates participating in their first international genetically engineered machine, or iGEM, competition. It teaches them how to use synthetic biology principles to design, build, and test biological projects over the summer. It all comes down to a championship jamboree in October. Their goal is to create a solar-based biofuel. The idea is simple. Cut dependency on fossil fuels pumped from the ground or the ocean by using a more natural source, waste from plants or sawdust from trees. They use the cellulose and convert that into a product called butanol, a biofuel.
It can be used at a mixture of up to 85%, so it's a pretty significant contribution. Projects like this that are working to produce butanol or other products, what they do is they reduce our dependence on fossil fuels.
The process is similar to fermenting beer, but instead of making ethanol, they're making butanol, which is something that you can't drink, but is something that could fuel cars. Since June, undergraduate, graduate students, and scientists have been working to that end, trying to reduce our dependence on fossil fuels by extracting the carbon from plants to create a more sustainable biofuel, one that is environmentally friendly.
We're trying to make a situation where plants will extract the CO2 out of the atmosphere, and then we'll use those plants to create this biofuel that we can run our vehicles on.
Although iGEM is a competition, the hands-on experience these students have gained in this lab setting has already benefited them.
It's given me more of an insight of what we can really accomplish with the skills that I'm learning in my major. For example, like, I didn't know all this was possible with bioengineering when I wasn't involved with research.
There are bragging rights and awards at stake in the iGEM competition, but these students believe they've accomplished something already.
For some of us, we've already succeeded. UCSC didn't previously have an iGEM team, and we've established that, and I think this will be a permanent presence here at the university.
And they'll know in a month if their project is successful, just in time for their trip to the finals that will be held on the MIT campus in Boston. Erin?
All right. Thank you, Phil. At that conference in Boston, the team will be joined by more than 400 others from universities around the world. They'll give an oral and poster presentation of their work, as well as submit a wiki webpage.